Hello. This is number 15 in the series History of Jazz. This session featuring the original Memphis Five. The exciting, vibrant sounds of the original Memphis Five are overwhelmingly joyous. Such intensity of happy feelings are rarely met with. The OM5 was unlike any other small jazz band of the 20s. To begin with, they're hardly ever, if at all, mentioned in jazz history books, and yet they exerted the greatest influence of all such jazz bands on the public. They did not play at the usual dance halls, or unusual ones for that matter, nor did they make the obligatory tours which so exhaust musicians. They were a studio group. This meant that they only existed to make records, rather than perform for the public. And make records they did. They made more records than any other group of their time. Just how many they made is still up for discussion, as they recorded for the majority of existing record companies under a host of pseudonyms. In addition to their official name, they recorded as Bailey's Lucky Seven, The Cotton Pickers, Jazzbo's Carolina Serenaders, Ladd's Black Aces, Lannan's Southern Serenaders, McMurray's California Thumpers, New Orleans Blackbirds, and Tennessee Ten. As a matter of fact, their official name is neither original, they didn't come from Memphis, nor were they always five in number. The founding members, Frank Signorelli on piano and Phil Napoleon trumpet, were the original groupies of the original Dixieland jazz band that we heard last session, the first jazz band to make recordings. They and their friends, Miff Mole on trombone, Jimmy Lytell on clarinet, and Jack Roth drums, would follow the ODJB from one job to job and another job, even to sitting in with their idols when one or several wouldn't happen to show up for the job. Frank Signorelli was the luckiest and actually got to record with the ODJB. Memphis Glide, the first that we'll listen to, is an original composition by the joint leaders Frank Signorelli and Phil Napoleon. And it stomps off, as we'll hear. This performance serves to introduce us to the unique, lively ensemble sound of the original Memphis Five, the driving lead of trumpeter Napoleon, the snappy interchange between Napoleon and pianist Signorelli, and the ending with which they signed off most numbers. While not achieving the status of a popular hit, it was recorded by them several times. And here is the original Memphis Five with their original composition, Memphis Glide.
Thank you.
was Memphis Glide by the original Memphis Five. The next is another original effort by the leaders Frank Signorelli and Phil Napoleon. It's called Snuggle Up a Bit. It's a more gutsy, bluesy feeling predominates in this selection, with a decidedly funky piano accompaniment from Signorelli. The specificity of the original Memphis Five gave them a unique standing in the recording business. Their special sound, mainly emanating from Phil Napoleon, and easy tempos made their music ideal for dancing. In this group, the distinctive sounds occur when the two leaders play a chorus together. Napoleon invariably mutes his trumpet to provide a more intimate feeling, which allows Signorelli's sensitive and rhythmical piano backing to provide the basic animation and impetus for the rest of the band. Jimmy Lytle's clarinet is a direct inspiration from the original Dixieland jazz band's Larry Shields, but with a fuller tone. Their drive and ability to ad-lib made their music ideal for listening. As a result, the original Memphis Five made a profound impression on the record-buying public during the 1920s, one which is still not fully appreciated. This is probably the only jazz group which remained fairly anonymous despite their readily identifiable sound, but whose collective record sales were phenomenal. Our next selection, Railroad Man, is a bouncy, toe-tapping tune of the early 20s written by Elmer Schobel, pianist of the New Orleans Rhythm Kings. Featuring banjoist Ray Kitchingman, there is a strong trombone interlude by Charles Pinelli, and then a most delightful Napoleon Signorelli byplay, with Signorelli flying through one of his invigorating runs, which typifies his exhilarating sound throughout this period. Our next selection, Pickles, is another finger snapper, composed by Charles Rossoff. Again, the happy banjo of Ray Kitchingman is heard, providing a strong supporting beat. Signorelli's solo clearly establishes him as one of the great pianists in an era of pretty spectacular solo pianists. Even more to his credit is his sympathetic accompaniment overall, which helps sustain the vivid original Memphis Five sound. Marvelous tune, Pickles, a 1924 tune by the original Memphis Five. The next Yankee Doodle Blues is a 1922 entry by George Gershwin. Hardly what one expected of a Gershwin song, yet the treatment is probably the best this tune ever received. Napoleon establishes the lead from the beginning and keeps it up intensely until the snap ending.
Thank you.
fabulous Yankee Doodle Blues by George Gershwin, as performed by the fabulous original Memphis Five. Gigi Boo, our next, features a nice crossplay between Napoleon and trombonist Miff Mole. Then it's time for the Napoleon Signorelli duet, followed by the rest of the band briskly playing the final chorus with tag ending. Fabulous. Of course, the original Memphis Five, one of the great groups of all time, unsung heroes. While their output was unusually large, the original Memphis Five's repertoire was not correspondingly large. This is accounted for by the fact that they would record the same tune for a dozen different recording companies. But this apparent drawback affords us the rare opportunity of listening to just how creative they were, as each rendition was a separate and individual one, not just the same take issued over and over again. On to the next selection. You notice that a lot of these in the 20s, and we will be noticing from now on, in the early 20s especially, the tunes have blues in the title. That was just a vogue word, as rag was 10 years earlier. Everything was this, that, and the other rag, when in fact they were nothing but pop songs. Here we have this, that, and the other blues, when in fact they're nothing but foxtrots. The next selection is a case in point. It's entitled Hopeless Blues, and it's neither hopeless nor is it a blues. One of the brighter efforts of J. Russell Robinson, whom you'll remember was one of the pianists for the ODJB, and Roy Turk, it features the clear and inspired clarinet artistry of Jimmy Lytle. Thank you. Memphis Blues. That'll teach you not to listen to titles. The next one is That Big Blonde Mama, which was written by Jimmy Monaco, and it was his contribution to the mama songs of the time. We're going to hear four of them in this series right now. While there is the very early rhythm banjo spot of Nick Lucas, the main attraction is the vital Phil Napoleon Frank Signorelli duet which surrounds it. The larger, fuller sound indicates that which is to come in popular dance music, while at the same time the small feature of the duet of the leaders identified the unique original Memphis Five sound to so many listeners. Big Blonde Mama by the original Memphis Five. What a phenomenal duet. It was a very unusual one, having, first of all, a cornet and a piano, and then interspersing it with the banjo replacing the piano, and then having the piano come back with the cornet. A highly unusual conception, but that's what made the original Memphis Five such a tremendous success with the listening public. Variety, easy listening, and yet clever arrangements to stimulate you if you just wanted to listen to them. Very easily danceable. Our next selection, Shufflin' Mose, is another Signorelli Napoleon original, and it's just dynamic. The Signorelli solo is highlighted by Jack Roth's effective drumming, which creates a contrasting shuffle sound. The cohesive ensemble for the rest of the piece demonstrated why they were so popular with the public. Their original composition, Shufflin' Mose. Shufflin' Mose by the original Memphis Five. The next is another original, an inspiration of Signorelli and Napoleon. Appropriately enough, gives emphasis to their outstanding duet as Napoleon's muted trumpet supplied the driving lead while Signorelli continuously provided incisive yet challenging improvisations. Great White Way Blues.
Thank you.
Great White Way Blues. A marvelously original composition. In fact, it was sort of popular. It was popular for its time, and it never escaped its time or transcended its time, because it was published. One of the few original Signorelli Napoleon tunes for the original Memphis Five that was published as a piece of sheet music. The next is a particular favorite of mine called Red Hot Mama, the second of the Mama songs that we'll hear in this show. It's a Fred Rose composition, and it allows the original Memphis Five's collective sound to be firmly established. There's ample room for Signorelli, however, to take a full chorus alone, and then have Napoleon on trumpet join in for another chorus. Red Hot Mama. Hot Mama, played by the fabulous original Memphis Five. And as far as original is concerned, they may not have been original with their name, but they certainly did not sound like the original Dixieland Jazz Band, their direct inspiration. And yet both of them, the ODJB and the OM5, created their own distinctive sounds with pretty much the same instrumentation. The next selection, I'm Going Back to Those Who Won't Go Back on Me, is a real treat for the interested listener in lovely, thoroughly neglected popular music. This is probably the only recording of this number, and it's a beaut. Clearly, Napoleon had a field day with it, and he received the support to forge ahead all the way. I'm Going Back to Those Who Won't Go Back on Me by the original Memphis Five. Thank you. wasn't that simply splendid? I'm going back to those who won't go back on me. In direct contrast to that, our next piece, Lonesome Mama Blues, the third in our Mama Songs, was a terrifically popular piece. But here, the original Memphis Five give it a lusty, forceful treatment, which was a most unusual one for this tear-jerking blues. Lonesome Mama Blues. Our next Strutton' Jim is another lovely early 20s gem, which is totally forgotten today. Its composer was Bob Carlton, who 5 years before had a fantastic smash hit in Jada. The haunting chorus in Jim is given fine ensemble treatment, typical of the OM5, and yet so untypical of any other group of its time. This song sports an unusually fine verse. The Signorelli piano accompaniment to Napoleon's muted trumpet gives way to a rare Signorelli solo, which in turn smoothly heralds the band for a rousing finish. Strutton' Jim.
Thank you.
Fantastic. Strut and Jem. See what I mean by the original Memphis Five? I hope you're listening and being able now to recognize this unique sound of this band. A very early jazz band from New York City, the original Memphis Five. Winding up this particular session of History of Jazz, the original Memphis Five plays another Elmer Schobel tune, another because we listened to Railroad Man earlier by him. This is called, and this finally finishes up, by the way, the fourth Mama song, Lots of Mama. Finishes this tribute to pioneer jazz band, the original Memphis Five, by featuring the entire group in an intense arrangement, allowing for the vivacious group feeling to express itself in a most free-flowing and spirited way. For the first half, Napoleon dominates as usual, with breaks punctuated by Miff Mole. From a beautiful series of harmonies, the band surges forward to the robust conclusion. Here is the original Memphis Five doing Lots of Mama.